close to that.
Thank you.
16, is this me?
Thank you.
Well, I think the Saucers were here 3 years ago, but I think the first time I came here was probably in 1967. I don't know if any of you remember the Jimi Hendrix tour that came here. No, you've all forgotten, have you? It's really sad. I was going to offer bonus points if you could actually name any of the bands that were on the list. So I'll just keep them for myself. What? Amen Corners, good, yes. Yes, good, the move, fantastic. Yeah, seems we've got stuck there. Very good, and never mind if the memory is going a bit. A friend of mine said to me recently, it means you can hide your own Easter eggs. Anyway, that was a track called One of These Days, which is more or less how we finished 3 years ago. We've been waiting ever since to get back to work. But finally, we are. Thank you.
Close, oh, moonshine wash. Thank you.
and performed by Sid Barrett. It's a moment of remembrance. Some of them are rather curious songs. I mean, Arnold Lane is quite well known because it was our bid for stardom. With that, we could be on top of the pops and move forward. We were mistaken because the BBC decided it was not suitable. Well, not suitable for anything, really. And it was banned, which should have probably been a bad thing, but maybe in the end it was good. Anyway, we decided that tonight it would be okay to play it. You're all quite grown up. second string, we considered using the B-side as the single. But that was doomed as well, because although we now call it Candy in a Currant Bun, at the time it was called Let's Roll Another One. The BBC thought it was almost as dangerous as Arnold Lane. And then finally, Vegetable Man, which is the most extraordinary little portrait of Sid at that point, where he was beginning to fragment rather. And we rather failed to do anything about it, which was a great shame, really. But at that time, we were young and innocent and had no idea things such as mental health were not words we knew. Anyway, on that note, we'll continue.
If I were a swan, I'd be gone. If I were a train, I'd be late. If I were a good man, I'd talk with you more often than I do. Thank you. would bend. If I were a good man, I'd understand the spaces between friends.
Grandfather.
active room now to introduce the band to anyone unfamiliar with them. It's always a great test of my memory of this. But first, on guitar and vocals, Mr. Lee Harris. Lee gets a special mention in dispatches because he was the guy who actually came up with this idea. Lee and John Perry, anyway. Bit of an in joke there. It was Lee's idea, and he persuaded Guy that it was a good idea, and then they came and worked on me, and I absolutely bought into it, and they then sold me some timeshares in Spain, some public glazing, and enormously successful. And then, fresh from 14 hours of working with the Orb at some trance festival, I imagine. Mr. Don Began. Thank you very much. On bass guitar and vocals, a man I've known for over 36 years and worked with for about that amount of time, Mr. Guy Pratt. People who knew other people came and joined in. And initially, I think this man thought he was going to be working with Roger Waters. He was wrong, but then I thought I was going to be working with Tony Hadley. Mr. Gary Penn.
Actually, the tragedy is that I thought I was going to be working with Nick Mason's Victoria's Secret. I still hope he ain't. It's a great honour for me to stand on this stage. I think we can all agree that sometime in the late 60s, early 70s, music changed the cultural landscape. And as young people, we bought records that we thought were the greatest things we'd ever heard in our lives. 50 years later, they still are the greatest things we've ever heard in our lives. One of them are the players they get, and one of the men who helped make that music is on stage. He's on drums, Mr. Nick Mason.
For me, this is a very special moment because I get to play the gong, which was something I've been expecting for many years. And I'm going to be assisted by the young gongster, Mr. Guy Pratt.
tonight.
I know, right? Yeah.
Only cramping the feet, so they fucking fidget.
You would frame that or keep it.
Pin it.
You wouldn't pin it. It's solid, isn't it?
Yeah, solid.
Yeah, they are.
But all of them?
Yeah, the drum heads are, yeah. Signed by Nick. I think it's 65 or something.
kind of all got the recent tug of the love.
Thank you. school, so I always thought Pink Floyd was this sort of rock band. It was funny because, of course, everyone used to play it because it was on Relics, the album with a cover by Nick Mason. Which, of course, the album that everyone had because it was half the price of all the other Pink Floyd records. A few weeks ago, Nick and I were involved in another little project some of you might have seen something about, when we made a record with Andriy Kilnyev, the Ukrainian rock singer. And I think it needs to be applauded for realising that by sticking those two little words in front of it, Pink Floyd, you could do something that might raise a little bit of hope and a little bit of help for the brave people of Ukraine.
Thank you.
Portsmouth. It's nice to be by the sea. And it's nice to see some faces that must have seen the show about 8 times. Aren't you? A few of you out there, yeah. But when I look out there and I see these t-shirts that some of you wear, it sort of inspires us to find guests for Rock On Tours, our podcast. I don't know whether anyone has been listening to that particularly. Yeah.
Four.
A few more shouts. If you don't know it, go to any podcast platform, Rock On Tours, me and Guy talking to different guests every week. Any particular favourites? Rick Astley. Rick was surprising. His first gig he ever saw was Camel.
Yeah, there's always Prog. No matter who it is, Prog is in there.
David Coverdale.
That's a big tune for sure.
But the thing is, when I see these t-shirts, like, you know, whatever it might be, Gentle Giant or Uriah Heep, I wonder where the fucking Spandau Ballet t-shirts are. One day, right, you'll look back. Should we do another Sid song?
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Yeah.
Seen it more than once, just for that alone.
Yeah. if only. One,
two,
three, four. I got a life, you can buy a ticket like it's got a pass. It's a bell that rings and makes the baby look. I'd give it to you if I could, but I wanted it. You're the kind of girl that fits in with my bone. I'll give you anything,
everything. Don't do it, I don't know.
Thank you again. Brilliant audience. Love it.